Getting rid of Copilot in Microsoft Office apps. Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. There are supposedly going to be some easier ways, as in a checkbox, to get Copilot at least turned off in your Microsoft apps. For now, that doesn't appear to be the case. Unfortunately, what that means is we need a more convoluted approach, at least until such a setting is added. The potential bonus, however, is that this more difficult method may turn off more than just Copilot and may increase your privacy beyond just what Copilot sees. So I'm going to go ahead and run Microsoft Word. This is a setting that you may end up having to change in each Office application. On the other hand, it might not be. This is part of the confusion associated with this particular setting. But we're going to run through it and we'll see what happens. Now, if you don't have a document open, you'll get a screen very much like this in Word. If you happen to have a document open, like I've just opened this blank document, you may need to click on the File menu in order to expose the Options link down here in the lower left. We'll click on that. Then we're going to click on Trust Center. In the next dialog, then we'll click on Trust Center Settings. Then we'll click on Privacy Options. Then we'll click on Privacy Settings. And finally, in this dialog box on Privacy Settings, we'll scroll down and we will turn off the connected experiences that analyze your content. As it turns out, Copilot is considered to be one of those. The reason I say that we may be disabling a few more things and increasing your privacy just a little bit more is that this setting appears to be generic for anything that Word would be uploading or sharing with the online servers. So we'll simply turn this off. I'm also going to go ahead and turn off the experiences that download online content. That one's totally up to you. I'll click on OK, and you'll notice that it says you need to restart Office in order to apply this setting. That's fine. We'll do that in a moment. So you can see then that it says restart Office to apply the changes to your privacy settings. You can click on that and it just gives you a description as to why. So what we really need to do then, of course, is to exit Microsoft Word. Now, if I do restart Word, then the setting that we just set should in fact be set the way we wanted it to. The reason that I am hesitant in saying that this is going to be the case, and indeed the setting is correct here, the reason that I'm hesitant about this is that in my experimentation with this setting, you may need to actually reboot your machine. Now, in this case, I've changed only in Microsoft Word. Once again, in my experience, the same setting is available in Microsoft Excel and some of the other Office applications, but it wasn't until I rebooted the machine that the setting was actually applied across all of the applications. So my recommendation for now is that you indeed make this change, and in doing so, make sure you're in a position where after making the change, you can not only restart the Office app that you made it in, but you can actually reboot your computer completely. So, bottom line here is if you want to play with Copilot and its related features in Office, and it's offered to you in Office, leave it alone. Go ahead. Pretty much this is what I'm doing on my main machine. But if you're concerned at all about the information being sent to Microsoft, or you're just not ready for the whole AI thing yet, well, you now have a way to turn off this Microsoft encouraged feature. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/177814. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.